Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1827A, Hide Value in Formula Bar. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in by Frank S. Is it possible to hide the value that shows in the formula bar? Yep, we're back to this Microsoft Excel ad, and a lot of people that I respect are weighing in, and I absolutely respect Ed Bott that we are spending way too much time on this. It's just a trivial thing, but hey, I'm Mr. Excel, and that's what we do. Woody Leonard, it's not a flaw in Excel. It's a poorly doctored screenshot displaying an apparently impossible state, and the reason that this keeps coming up is if you look at the ad, there's nothing in the formula bar, even though that this cell is selected. All right, so here in my last video, I talked about this was a poorly contrived formula. I still stand by that. We're going to insert a new row after hotel. We're going to type car. We're going to type 500 and control enter. And I agree that this does not look like that. However, let's select all cells, control 1, go back to the protection tab, turn on hidden, uncheck locked, click OK, still showing 500, but then we go to the review tab and turn on protect sheet, click OK, and we now have exactly what is shown in the ad. That's how I think it happened. Now, why do I continue to pour gasoline on this fire? Well, because this weekend, Frank Shaw, a Microsoft PR guy, said, hey, no, the ad is correct. When using Excel, AutoSum recalculates after editing. And kudos to Brad Sams, who in this video showed how that is theoretically possible. I'll put the link in the description here at YouTube, but let's try and replicate that. So what Frank is saying is that they properly use the sum function down here. Great, 9,500. So then like Brad did, we would delete this and actually type $500 and not press enter. All right, and sure enough, Excel has not calculated it yet because we have not pressed enter. However, in this case, if what Frank Shaw says is correct, then the 500 wouldn't be showing there. What would have to happen is when I press enter, three things happen. The 500 is going to disappear. The car is going to appear in the chart, and then the animation is going to kick in at the 9,500. So the only way that this could have happened the way that Frank says that it happened is when I press enter, this has to hide, this has to update before the animation kicks in. It'll be too fast. Let's see if we can slow it down maybe. Hey, now I'm in Camtasia. This absolutely proves that I have no life. We're looking at this one frame at a time. So I'm going to press the right arrow key. All right. So I've just pressed enter, and sure enough, the 500 does disappear from there. But we already see the animation starting to roll in, and the chart hasn't updated. Now, that's the first 30th of a second. I'll press the right arrow key again. And in the second 30th of a second, the chart has updated, but the 9,500 is appearing. So Frank, there's really no way. So kudos to Frank. That was a great PR move, plausible deniability, but I just don't buy it. Maybe it was Photoshop, but I still think it was a bad formula. They inserted the row, added the item, protected the sheet, which gets the 500 out of the formula bar, and never updated the formula. So there you go, how to hide the value in the formula bar. A few more things to match the screen. We want to minimize the ribbon, and you see that none of the ribbon tabs are selected. Of course, we'd have to sign out as me, sign in as Katie Jordan, whoever this person was. But anyway, thanks to David Yanofsky, who broke the original story, Brad Sams, who showed me how to get that value right justified as we type it in, and also Alex Wilhelm on TechCrunch had a great story collecting all this information. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.